Welcome to Learn Commerce PU Online Classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello students, welcome to First PUC Business Studies Online Classes. Students, in the previous class we have concluded general principles of insurance, right? Which are applicable to most of the insurance contracts like life, marine and fire and other insurance, isn't it? So here, now let us move on to the next part, that is topic, that is types of insurance. Types of insurance. See friends, there are three types actually, but I have made as a broad category here, that is life insurance and general insurance. As I already I have explained regarding the difference between life insurance and general insurance, you may be knowing, right? In my previous class I have explained regarding this. That is, life insurance is a contract of guarantee. There is assurance, it is life assurance, because guaranteed return will be there, isn't it? But general insurance, there is no guaranteed return. To get anything, any benefit, there must be some mishap, isn't it? Some unforeseen contingency must happen, otherwise no compensation will be paid, amount will not be returned under any circumstances, correct? So that is called general insurance. Now, let us take up first one, life insurance. As I have already explained regarding life insurance, it is the insurance taken on the life of a person. Life of a person. So here, the person who issues insurance policy or who undertakes to compensate is called the insurer, that is insurance company, like I have explained earlier, isn't it? And the person who is being compensated, isn't it? He is called insured. The person on whose life the insurance policy is taken, or the person who purchases insurance policy from the insurance company and whose life is taken as a subject matter, he is called insured. And there will be a contract of insurance which is called contract of insurance, and the document which is given by the insurer to the insured as a proof of contract of insurance is called policy, is called insurance policy. It is a document, legal document, which is prepared and given by the insurer to the insured, and insured must agree and he has to put his signature. Once the insured agrees for the terms and conditions that are mentioned in the policy, then the contract of insurance will start. Clear? And policy contains all the terms and conditions of the contract of insurance. Policy and reno undo paper illi navu en martteve a bond antu karitheve navu LIC bond anta adralli ella terms and conditions irthade yara hesaralli insurance avana address avana aadhar number athava enadidre date of birth then yari kodbeku ava expire adre yari kodbeku isn't it yavaga hana kodteve insurance company helutade isn't it premium eshtu varshikava aaru thingaligommeya mooru thingaligommeya monthly isn't it whether it is a salary deduction or the insured will pay on his own, all these things ella en ella ide insurance policy idu madaboda pledge madaboda adru eshtu samayad nantara en aagtade suppose moor premium kattade eradu premium katti naavu cancel madidre aga en aagtade aa hana vapas sigudilla namge isn't it ಮೂರು ವರ್ಷ ಕಟ್ಟಿದ್ರೆ ಸರೆಂಡರ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಅಂತ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹಣವನ್ನು ವಾಪಸ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ ಸೊ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಪೇ ದ ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ವಿಲ್ ಪೇ ಸರೆಂಡರ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇಫ್ ತ್ರೀ ಕಾನ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟಿವ್ ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪೇಯ್ಡ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ 1 lakh insurance policies taken on the life. First premium 5000 is paid, second premium 5000 is paid, and from third onwards it is not paid, then this amount will not be returned, friends. Remember this. But if you have paid three consecutive premiums, then you will get surrender value. Either nantar you got leave, it is discontinued after 3 years. Three premiums have been paid continuously, then you, the insured, will get some amount, not the entire amount. 15,000 is paid here, maybe 9,000 or 10,000 will be returned as surrender value. Surrender value. There is procedure for that. You have to follow that procedure and you will get some amount out of that. Otherwise, if only two premiums are paid, money will not be returned. Clear? So that is what about life insurance is. So here we call this as policy, the terms and conditions which are mentioned in a document is called policy, isn't it? And the insurer will compensate to the insured on happening of the mishap, that is death of the insured must be there, then the amount will be compensated to the legal representatives of the insured, isn't it? So make sure of this point. If the person still alive after the term of the policy, that is after the expiry of the term of the policy, then the compensation will be paid to the legal representatives, maybe wife or the near relation, blood relation, they will be given the compensation. So this is about the contract of, that is a life insurance, and this is called life assurance rather than life insurance, because the amount is, return is assured, guaranteed, correct? So this contract is called the contract of guarantee, and all other, that is insurance contracts are called contract of indemnity, because they indemnify the loss only. They will not pay addition amount, extra amount will not be paid. Here you will get extra, that is a bonus also will be given along with some assured, depending upon the type of policy, right? Now what are the principles, general principles of life insurance? Let us analyze. First one is, it should have all the essentials of a valid contract. Essentials of a valid contract. What do you mean by valid contract? Valid contract means the contract which is done, which is entered into as per the Indian Contract Act 1872. There is a Contract Act 1872, Indian Contract Act 1872, as per the, that is provisions of that act, if a contract is entered into, then it is called valid contract. So all the essentials of a valid contract must be there in the case of life insurance. What are those essentials of valid contract? There must be offer. The insurer must offer a policy to the insured. There must be acceptance of the policy. There must be acceptance. So, essentials of valid contract are, that is the offer, acceptance. The other person must accept. Offer will be given by the insurer to the insured, and insured must accept it. If it is not accepted, it is not a contract of insurance. Remember, it is not a contract at all. Then, consideration. There must be proper consideration which should move from one party to the other. Here, consideration is premium that is paid by insured to the insurer, and consideration that is paid by insurer is, he will undertake to compensate if anything happens. Otherwise also, he will return the amount with vested bonus, isn't it? That is consideration. Consideration means something in return. quid pro quo, we call it as, you know, call it in as a legal term. Don't worry about this term. You will study it in degree classes. Okay, there will be a contract act. You have to study in detail. There you will come to know. For the time being, just remember that is something in return. I'll give best example. If I have to give this chalk piece to you, you have to pay the amount. If you go to shop and if you want to purchase a chalk piece, you should pay money, right? What is the consideration you are giving? You are giving money to the shopkeeper. What is the consideration he gives for that? He will give chalk piece to you. So chalk piece and money will be exchanged. That is consideration for each other. For a shopkeeper, consideration is value of the chalk, that is amount, isn't it? Money. And for you, consideration is chalk piece. You are paying the money and you are getting the chalk piece, isn't it? So that is consideration. Very simple, friends. So consideration, then free consent. Free consent, the acceptance must be received with the free consent of the insured. Insurer cannot threaten. He should not threaten the insured to accept the policy, isn't it? Policy nu maadlebeku illadra naale belige neen illa nan vyavasthe maartene adike, isn't it? This will not happen, should not happen, because it is illegal. It is illegal. A insurance ಕಂಪನಿ ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್ ಏಜೆಂಟ್ ಯಾರು ಇರ್ತಾರೆ, ಏಜೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ, ಮನೆಗೆ ಒಂದು ಜೀವ ತಿಂತಾರೆ ಕೆಲವೊಮ್ಮೆ, ಅದೇ ಮೇಟ್ ಹರ್ಡ್ ಮೇಟ್ ಸೀನ್ ಅಸೆಂಟ್ ಇಟ್. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ನಾವು ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್ ಪಾಲಿಸಿ ತಗೊಳ್ಳುವಾಗ ಅವನಿಂದ ಬಲವಂತವಾಗಿ ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್ ಪಾಲಿಸಿಯನ್ನು ತಗೊಳ್ಳುವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಅಥವಾ ಬಲವಂತವಾಗಿ ಅವನ ಒಪ್ಪಿಗೆಯನ್ನು ಸೈನ್ ಮಾಡು, ಸೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀಯ ಇಲ್ವಾ, ಇಲ್ಲಾದ್ರೆ ಏನೋ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ನೀವು ಥ್ರೆಟನಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದ ಫ್ರೀ ಕನ್ಸೆಂಟ್. ನಾನು ಮನಸ್ಪೂರ್ವಕವಾಗಿ ನಾನು ಸ್ವ ಇಚ್ಛೆಯಿಂದ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಹಿ ಹಾಕಬೇಕು. ನಾನೀಗ ಇನ್ಶೂರ್ಡ್ ಆದರೆ ನಾನು ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್ ಪಾಲಿಸಿ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗುವಾಗ ನನ್ನ ಮೇಲೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯ ಬಲವಂತ ಇರಬಾರ್ದು. ಯಾರ್ದೋ ಒತ್ತಡಕ್ಕೆ ಮಣಿದು ನಾನು ಸಿಗ್ನೇಚರ್ ಹಾಕಿಕೊಂಡು ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್ ಪಾಲಿಸಿ ತಗೊಳ್ಬಾರ್ದು. ನನಗೆ ಬೇಕು ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್, ನಾನು ನನ್ನ ಲೈಫನ್ನು ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಸ್ವ ಇಚ್ಛೆಯಿಂದ ಸಹಿ ಹಾಕಿ ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್ ಪಾಲಿಸಿ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ, ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಕನ್ಸೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ದರ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಫ್ರೀ ಕನ್ಸೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಟು ದ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಕೆಪ್ಯಾಸಿಟಿ ಟು ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್. ಕೆಪ್ಯಾಸಿಟಿ ಟು ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್? ಹೀ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ಸೇನ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಆರ್ ಮೈನರ್. ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಡನ್, ಬಟ್ in case of minors, the legal guardian, isn't it, in their name the policy will be issued and it will be written as minor within bracket, isn't it? So there must be capacity to contract. That is, capacity to contract means the person must have the capacity to enter into a valid contract, should be above the age of majority, isn't it? All these things must be there. But on minors also you can take insurance policy, no problem for that, but it will be issued in the name of what, the legal guardian or the parent. So these are the essentials of a valid contract, must be there for a insurance contract, isn't it? So that is first, that is a principle. Second one is, there must be utmost good faith. I have already explained regarding utmost good faith. That is, both the parties to the contract of insurance, that is insured and the insurer, must disclose all material facts to each other. They should not hide or conceal any material fact. ಈಗಾಗಲೇ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೇನೆ, ಆ ಇಬ್ಬರು ಪಾರ್ಟಿ ಯಾರಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಇನ್ಶೂರ್ಡ್ ಮತ್ತು ಇನ್ಶೂರರ್, ಅವರೇನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಅವರಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದ್ದ ವಿಷಯವನ್ನು ಎಲ್ಲವನ್ನು ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬರಿಗೆ ಹೇಳಬೇಕು. ಆ ಇನ್ಶೂರ್ಡ್ಗೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಗೊತ್ತಿರ್ತದೆ, ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಅವನ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ, ಅವನ ಲೈಫ್, ಅವನ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಹೇಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ, ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ನಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ಮುಚ್ಚುಮರೆ ಮಾಡದೆ ಅವನು ಎಲ್ಲವನ್ನು ಹೇಳಬೇಕು. ಅವನು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸರ್ ಇಂದ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ 3 ತಿಂಗಳವರೆಗೆ ನಿನ್ನ ಟಿಕೆಟ್ ಕನ್ಫರ್ಮ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಹೇಳಬೇಕು. ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗ್ತದಾ, 3 ತಿಂಗಳ ನಂತರ ನಾನು ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಗ್ಯಾರಂಟಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 3 ಮಂತ್ಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಟಿಕೆಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕನ್ಫರ್ಮ್ಡ್, ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್? ಅದನ್ನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ನೀವು ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ಹತ್ರ ಹೇಳಬೇಕು. ನೀವು ಅದರ ನಂತರವೂ ಅವರು ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್ ಪಾಲಿಸಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟರು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಲಕ್, ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್? ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಎ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್. ಅದರ್ವೈಸ್ it will be void contract. Void andre adu contract agodilla alli insurance company non compensation kodudilla ant helabodu death aad kodle. So that is called utmost good faith. Okay, then next one is insurable interest. In this case, life insurance, isn't it? When we take out an insurance policy on the life of a person, then the person who is taking out insurance policy, maybe husband is taking, Mr. A and Mrs. A, isn't it? Mr. A takes out an insurance policy on Mrs. A's life. After paying the premium, Mr. A, if kills Mrs. A, do you think it is a contract of insurance? No, this will not happen. This should not happen. Or an insurance policy is taken on the house, and next day I will bring maybe 10 liters of petrol and I will pour and I will set on fire my house itself, because I know that it is in old condition now. So let it burn. I will construct a new house by taking compensation from the insurance company. So this is not correct, because principle of insurable interest says that the insured must protect the property insured or the subject matter of insurance from all reasonable care and caution. He should take all reasonable steps to protect the property from any mishap. ಅದು ಡೆಸ್ಟ್ರಾಯ್ ಆಗುವ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ರೂ ಕೂಡ ಅದನ್ನು ಡೆಸ್ಟ್ರಾಯ್ ಆಗದ ಹಾಗೆ ಜಾಗ್ರತೆ ವಹಿಸಬೇಕು, ಅದರ ರಕ್ಷಣೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್ ಪಾಲಿಸಿ ತಗೊಂಡ ನಂತರ ಅವರ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ನಾವು ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿರಬೇಕು. ಒಂದು ವೇಳೆ ಜ್ವರ ಏನಾದರೂ ಬಂದರೆ, ಶೀತ ಬಂದರೆ, ಕೋವಿಡ್ ಬಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಜಾಗ್ರತೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್, ಎಸ್, ದಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಡನ್. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ಶೂರೇಬಲ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್. ದ ಇನ್ಶೂರ್ಡ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಇನ್ಶೂರೇಬಲ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂದ ಅವ್ರ ಮಾನಿಟರಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂದ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಲೈಫ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಶ್ಯೂರ್ ಇನ್ಶೂರ್ಡ್, ಇಸ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್. ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡೆಮ್ನಿಟಿ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡೆಮ್ನಿಟಿ. ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ಇಂಡೆಮ್ನಿಟಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಗ್ಯಾರಂಟಿ? ಇಂಡೆಮ್ನಿಟಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ only loss will be compensated, the entire amount will not be paid. Suppose Mr. A took out an insurance policy for 1 crore, the entire amount will not be paid if there is a loss. Depending upon the amount of loss suffered by Mr. A, the insurance company will compensate. That is called a contract of indemnity. What is a contract of guarantee then? Life insurance, it is a contract of guarantee and not indemnity, because if the person survives even after the expiry of the term of policy, suppose insurance policy is taken for a period of 20 years, after 20 years Mr. A still survives, wasn't it? He didn't die. So in that case, the entire amount will be paid. Entire amount will be paid along with the vested bonus to Mr. A by the insurance company. So here the return is guaranteed. Return is guaranteed. There is no compromise, isn't it? If Mr. A expires after 1 month, suppose insurance premium is paid, isn't it? Immediately contract starts. Then Mr. A expires, maybe after 1 year or 2 years Mr. A expires, then the family members will be compensated. The legal representatives of the deceased person or the insured will be compensated by the insurance company with the total amount of the policy. The sum assured will be given along with vested bonus. So that is called, it is not a contract of indemnity, but it is a contract of guarantee. In either case, whether the insured or the assured, we call it as assured and assurer, isn't it? Because there is a guarantee. So if in case Mr. there is a assured survives or expires, in both the cases the amount is guaranteed either to the legal representatives in case of his death or to himself in case he survives even after the term of the policy, expiry of the term of the policy. So that is a contract of guarantee. So insurance contract is something different from the general insurance, right? Yes. Now let us move on to the types of policies, life insurance policies. A few are mentioned here, but there are many policies. If you go to insurance company, every day they are coming with the new products. Everything is not mentioned here. So let us analyze what are the policies that are given. Whole life policy, first one is whole life policy, WHOLE, not HOLE policy, remember, whole life policy. That is here, the whole life till the end of the insured's or assured's life, isn't it? It is protected, his life is protected till the end of his life. Sometimes you pay in there is a amount, lumps in one lump sum, isn't it? Maybe. And after the expiry of the, that is after the death of that person, the amount will be compensated, will be given to the family, isn't it? Do you think it is good? I don't think so, because we are paying amount and someone else enjoys, isn't it? So in insurance, the mishap should happen, then only more benefit will be there. Otherwise, no. If he survives, he will get. Otherwise, someone else will enjoy, isn't it? Yes, whatever it is, let us come to the point here. Whole life means the entire life of the that is assured is confirmed, isn't it? Is protected, fully protected. Second one is endowment policy. Endowment policy. Here you have to pay amount for a certain period of time, then till the end of the life of the person will be protected. That is called endowment policy. Third one is joint life policy, JLP. Joint life policy. It's very good. Here the policy will be taken on the lives of both husband and wife, spouse especially, isn't it? Or partners, Mr. A and B, isn't it? Or A, B, C, three partners are there, one policy will be taken. And if in case of death of any one of the persons, isn't it, then amount will be compensated. The policy amount will be given, the assured amount will be given. So husband and wife, Mr. A and Mrs. A, policy is taken on the life of both, lives of both the both husband and wife, then it is called a joint life policy. If anyone expires or dies, then the other one will get the compensation, correct? That is called joint life policy. Then annuity policy. Annuity policy. Here you have to pay yearly premium, isn't it? And after certain years, maybe after the attainment of that is 60 years, age of 60 or 55, the person will get continuously till the death of that person, amount, a certain amount will be paid as that is a compensation. Okay, it's like a regular, that is a pension, in the same way the person will get by insuring or protect, I mean, that is insuring his life, isn't it? Children endowment policy, again it is the same thing. Children endowment policy. Here what we'll do is when the child is a small kid, isn't it, then we will insure the life of that child. Anything happens, the parents will get compensation. Otherwise after certain age, maybe after when the child reaches the age of 18 or 20, 21, something like that, during that time you need to join the child to, that is maybe courses, different education courses, isn't it? Maybe doctor, engineer, for that you have to pay a huge amount. For that, if you insure the life of the child, then the child will get the benefit of continuing the education without financial problem, right? here life is also secured, and along with that a saving scheme, like so that is called children's, that is a policy, children endowment policy. So this is about the different policies. There are many more in case of life insurance. If you visit a life insurance company, then you will come to know the different types of policies, because they are coming out with the new policies every maybe once in fortnight, once in a month or something like that. And the old policy gets cancelled, then new policy, they will come out with more benefits and all these things, isn't it? Let us see. So that is about the types of life insurance policies. Whatever that is, the policies are given in your reader, you just go through that from examination point of view. To improve your knowledge, visit Life Insurance Corporation once and get the information from the development officers who will be there, or any that is manager in charge, ask them and get the information. Better you should, or you can search in the net, wasn't it? Net, you will get all the details regarding this. So increase your knowledge level. You should know everything, what is going on, you should know in and around, isn't it? Simply sticking on to your book will not help you. So make sure of it. Take down assignment. Mention different types of life insurance policies. Mention the different types of life insurance policies. Just mention, no need to explain, okay? Submit your assignment on time. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates. We'll be right back.